So good morning. So our presentation today we are going to learn on drilling bits. So what are the types of bits utilized in the oil and gas industry? So let's go to the presentation. So you know that the oil well drilling technologies are using different types of drill bits. So roller cone bits, rolling cutter bits, which is having a steel tooth, milled tooth, carbide tooth, tungsten, carbide inserts. So we are having also two cone bit, three cone bit, tri cone bit, and four cone bits. So it was introduced by 1909 by Howard Hughes. So rotary drill bits. So you're having two types. You can see in the diagram of this schematic. See tungsten carbide insert bit and milled tooth bit. And you can also see the what are the rock bit elements. So on the left side we are having a carbide tooth, then jet nozzle, nozzle boss, then compact land is there, then rear flank, front flank, inner end interruption, then root of tooth, nose of cone, steel tooth, heel row, then square point, middle row, nose row, cone shell, then crest of teeth, inner end of tooth and outer end of tooth. So this is the rock bit elements of the rotary drill bit, tungsten carbide insert bit and milled tooth bits. Next slide. So what are the rolling cutter bits? So tricone bits, the most common bit utilized. So it is having a different tooth design and bearing types, and it is utilized in the oil and gas well drilling technology. And maximum use is made of limited space, then cone offset is used to stop rotating periodically to scrap the hole like PCD bits, and also it increases the drill speed, or you can say the rate of penetration or whatever it is, but tooth wear is faster for soft formation and hard formation is zero, four for the soft formation. So based on the formation type, the drill bits are designed, soft formation or hard formation. So we'll see in detail later on, but now let's go to our next slide. Then rolling cutter bits, the shape of teeth. It is long, widely spaced steel teeth used for drilling the soft formations and also the different rock types, which are very harder. It is having the very good long tooth length and cone offset, which must be reduced to prevent the tooth breakage. So cone offset angle is there, we can see in the later on the further slides. Tooth action is called scraping and twisting. Zero offset cones action equal to crushing. And smaller tooth allows more room for the construction of stronger bearings. So this is a brief description of your rolling cutter bits and classification of trigone bits. So you have milled tooth cutters, then tungsten carbide insert bits, and a hard facing on one side of the teeth allows self sharpening and the chips tend to keep the tooth very sharp. Intermeshing is very advantageous and heel teeth equal to outer raw. It's a very difficult job, so that it wears, it leads to out of gauge bit. This is a tungsten carbide insets cutter used in rolling cutter bits. So you can see the different tungsten carbide inserts, gauge, compact, ovoid, conical chisels, wedge crested chisel, scoop chisel, blunt chisel, and sharp chisel. So what are the improvements? So three cone bit, so it's having straighter hole and intermeshing teeth for better cleaning, hard facing on teeth and body, steel tooth, that is milled tooth, carbide both sides, that is tungsten carbide inserts, change from water courses to jets and tungsten carbide inserts, sealed bearings and journal bearings. Advantages, so for any type of formation, it is a suitable design of rock bits, and also it can handle the any changes in the formations, and also the pricing is very cheaper and also a reasonable cost. So proper bottom hole cleaning is very important. You can see this, the fluid flow through the water courses in the drill bit. This is the schematic. Also here, fluid flow through jets, the bit nozzles. So milled tooth bit or steel tooth, which is having a long teeth for soft formations and shorter teeth for harder formations, and cone offset in soft formation results in scraping, or you can say gouging action. Shelf sharpening teeth is done by using hard facing on one side and gives the high drilling rates for softer rocks. So milled tooth bit, this steel tooth which is shown here, you can see this. Rolling cutter bits, that is tungsten carbide insert bits, which are very long life cutting structure for the hard rocks formation, and hemispherical inserts for very hard rocks, larger and more pointed inserts are for soft rocks, and it can handle high bit weights and high RPM rotation per minute. And inserts sometimes are failed through the breakage, then the wear, and this tungsten carbide is very hard and brittle material. So this is the description of tungsten carbide insert bits. So tungsten carbide insert bits schematic you can see here. This is roller cone bearings and ball bearings, point contact, roller bearings, line contact, journal bearings in the area contact, lubrications with drilling fluids. Then sealed bearings since 1959. So grease lubricants which are used for longer life. Then journal bearings, the area contact. So there is a wear resistant hard surface on the journals and the solid lubricants which are inside the cone journal. And O-ring sealings and greases are utilized. Then how do you grading of these dull bits? How do bits wear out? So tooth wear or loss, worn bearings and gauge wearing. So grading of dull bits. How do bits wear out? So the steel teeth which are graded in eighths of original tooth height, that has the worn away. So here you can see the tooth height measurements T1, T2, T3, T4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So here T3 means 3/8 of the original teeth height is the worn away. Worn means it is fallen, removed. Tungsten carbide insides. So here you can see the T3 means 3/8 of the inserts are broken or lost. You can see it in the diagram. B3 means an estimated 3/8 of the bearing life is gone. Balled up bits and cracked cone bits. So bits fail. Grinding of dull bits. So this is your washed out bit, and you can see the last cone. So this is grading of dull bits and gauge wear. So how you measure the gauge wear? So bit is either in the gauge or out of gauge. So measure the wear and the diameter by inches using a gauge ring. So T3, B3, I, T5, B4, 0/1/2. Then example is given. So we have made a brief introduction of the drill bits today. Thank you. So today we had a brief introduction of your drill bits, roller cone bits, and what are inserts and what are the dull blade system. We'll see in the next lecture. Thank you.